बिस्मिल्लाह
आई एम
रहमान
डॉक्टर
रहीम।
अश्रा
शैतान। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस प्रोटीन मिसफोल्डिंग। लर्निंग आउटकम्स और ऑब्जेक्टिव्स आर द प्रोटीन मिसफोल्डिंग, कॉन्फर्मेशनल डिजीजेस, बायोकेमिकल बेसिस एंड क्लिनिकल फीचर्स ऑफ अल्जाइमर डिजीज, टाइप्स, बायोकेमिकल बेसिस एंड क्लिनिकल फीचर्स ऑफ ट्रांसमिसिबल स्पॉन्जीफॉर्म एनकेफेलोपैथीज और प्राइन डिजीज। प्रोटीन फोल्डिंग इज अ कॉम्प्लेक्स प्रोसेस दैट कैन समटाइम्स रिजल्ट इन इम्प्रॉपरली फोल्डेड प्रोटीन। दीज मिसफोल्डेड प्रोटीन्स आर यूजुअली टैग एंड डिग्रेडेड विद इन द सेल। हाउएवर दिस क्वालिटी कंट्रोल सिस्टम इज नॉट परफेक्ट एंड इंट्रासेलुलर और एक्स्ट्रासेलुलर एग्रीगेट्स ऑफ मिसफोल्डेड प्रोटीन्स कैन अक्यूमुलेट। डिपॉजिट्स ऑफ दीज मिसफोल्डेड प्रोटीन्स आर एसोसिएटेड विद ए नंबर ऑफ डिजीजेज। मिसफोल्डिंग ऑफ प्रोटीन्स मे अकर स्पॉन्टेनियसली आर बी कॉज बाई म्यूटेशन इन अ पर्टिकुलर जीन विच देन प्रोड्यूस एन ऑल्टर्ड प्रोटीन। In addition, some apparently normal proteins can, after abnormal proteolytic cleavage, take on a unique conformational state that leads to the spontaneous formation of long fibrillar protein assemblies, which are consisting of beta pleated sheets. These insoluble fibrous proteins aggregates called amyloids. These amyloids may be implicated in the neurodegenerative disorder such as Parkinson's disease and Alzheimer's disease. Alzheimer's disease is not genetically based, although 5% of cases are familial. Mutation to presenilin, the catalytic subunits of gamma secretase, are most common cause of familial Alzheimer's disease. Dominant component of the amyloid plaque that accumulates in Alzheimer's disease is amyloid beta. Amyloid beta is an extracellular peptide of 42 monoacid residues. As I have already told you, amyloid beta is an extracellular peptide having 42 amino acids. When aggregate in a beta pleated sheet, conformation is neurotoxic and is leading to the cognitive impairment, which is the characteristics of the disease. The amyloid beta that is deposited in the brain in Alzheimer's disease is derived by the enzymic cleavages by secretases from the larger amyloid precursors of protein. Amyloid precursor is a single transmembrane protein expressed on the cell surface in the brain and other tissues. The amyloid beta peptide aggregate generating the amyloid that is found in the brain parenchyma and around blood vessels. A second biologic factor involved in the development of the Alzheimer's disease is the accumulation of the neurofibrillary tangles inside neurons. A key component of these tangles, fibers, is an abnormal form of the tau protein, which is hyperphosphorylated and insoluble form of normal tau protein. Normal tau protein helps in the assembly of the microtubular structure. The defective tau protein blocks the action of its normal counterpart. Apolipoprotein E has been implicated as a potential mediator of this conformational transformation. Amyloid beta or amyloid beta containing fragments are directly or indirectly neurotoxic. Exposure of neuron to amyloid beta, which is neurotoxic, can increase their intracellular concentration of calcium ion. Some protein kinases include that involved in the phosphorylation of tau protein are regulated by the level of calcium ions. Increase of calcium ion may lead to hyperphosphorylation of tau protein. X-ray crystallography and infrared spectroscopy demonstrates the characteristic beta pleated sheet conformation in non-branching fibrils. A key initial steps in the digestion of amyloid precursor protein by either alpha secretase or beta secretase producing smaller non-toxic products. Cleavage by alpha secretase may result in formation of alpha secretase product, and cleavage by beta secretase result in formation of beta secretase product. Both are non-toxic. Cleavage of the beta secretase product by gamma secretase result in either the toxic alpha amyloid beta 42, which containing 42 amino acids, or the non-toxic amyloid beta 40 peptide. Cleavage of the alpha secretase product by gamma secretase produces the non-toxic P3 peptide. Excess production of amyloid beta 42 is a key initiator of cellular damage in Alzheimer's disease. This is the diagrammatic representation of amyloid precursor protein and its cleavage. It is expressed on cell surface in the brain. We have already discussed, and it is single transmembrane protein. Amyloid precursor protein is encoded by a gene on chromosome 21. Cleavage of the beta secretase product by gamma secretase results in production of toxic amyloid beta 42 or non-toxic amyloid beta 40, as we have discussed in previous slide. Here we can see formation of amyloid plaque found in the Alzheimer's disease. As we have already discussed, that amyloid beta is formed by the cleavage of amyloid precursor protein. There is spontaneous aggregation of amyloid beta peptide to form amyloid plaque, which is the characteristic of Alzheimer's disease. Now, the clinical features of Alzheimer's disease. Clinical features include cognitive impairment, dementia, gradual memory loss, especially recent memory is more affected. There is confusion with time and space. Patients show decreased or poor judgment. Change in mood and personality is also observed. Sometimes patient present with the aggressive behavior. Patient with cognitive impairment present with the following symptoms: memory loss, he frequently asking the same question or repeating the same story over and over. He does not recognize familiar people and places. Patient having trouble in exercising judgment. There may be changes in mood and behavior. VN problem sometimes may occur. Patient may observe difficulty in planning and carrying out tasks. Patient feel that nothing is wrong with him and his attendant brought him to medical specialist. Treatment. No specific treatment. There is only symptomatic treatment. Symptoms such as depression, agitation, anxiety, and insomnia can be treated by appropriate drugs, and antipsychotic may be required if psychosis intervenes. Drugs like anticholinesterase and prevention is more important. The consumption of omega 3 fatty acid may prevent the Alzheimer's disease. The sources of today's lecture are Harper and Lippincott Biochemistry. Thank you very much, dear students.